Today I'm going to borrow from Monet. I'm going to do a water lily painting, and I'm going to try to keep it as sketchy as he did. I'm going to just lay in an area where I will put some lily pads. I will just put a few faint pencil lines in, just to give myself some ideas where I want my darks and lights shapes. Before I even get started painting, I like to make sure that all of my paints are reconstituted. I've had them in my palette for weeks, actually. I've chosen my favorite colors, and before I start to paint, I really soak them. And then I try to remember to come back and give them a good soaking occasionally throughout the painting so that nothing really dries up. I want paint that is a little bit sticky so that I can grab it with my brush. I'm taking a candle and I'm going to put some swirls in here. Put some swirls that I think they'll depict some beautiful light areas where the water will sparkle here and there. And this candle causes a resist where the paint won't quite stick to the paper. We'll see how that works. Next thing I want to do is grab some watercolor crayons, which are fun to play with. They're great fun to play with, and I'm going to really have at it with my watercolor crayons. These particular ones I'm using today are Carandash, but there are several brands. Daniel Smith makes a beautiful watercolor crayon, and they just work so nicely, give you really some very nice impressionistic marks. You'll see how all of this works. Some of these will diffuse. This will kind of give me an idea of where some of my darks are going to go. And I'll get another couple of colors out. So what I think we're going to do is have an impression of the sky reflecting in the water. There's not any magic to this, really. It's just Monet gave us the idea of making impressions of things. And how much more fun this is than trying to recreate a photograph. Why not play and make something loose and gestural? Time for paint. I'll show you what these look like all by themselves without adding any paint to them. If I don't scrub too much, you can see some of the texture of the watercolor pencil or crayon. WC got a little heavy there. Okay, let's see. This is a mop brush, and it's really nice to use for this type of painting because it's it holds a lot of water. It's just a small number two mop, but I can paint and paint with it. This area is wet in here. I'm going in to some actual watercolor. It's not important to me that I copy every single little detail that Monet used. I just wanted to get the effect of Monet's work, just the general feel of it. Already some of my colors are getting a little bit dry. It's a dry day today here. Some people might want to know what colors I'm using. And while for a long, long time, the specific pigment colors were terribly important, and I realize if you're not accustomed to using a specific palette, you want perhaps to have some help where to start, but I will say that the important thing is just get some good paints and start learning what they do. Figure out their properties, mix them together, see what combinations you can come up with. And I'm gonna let some watercolor do its thing in here. Make sure that there aren't too many hard edges. A little pigment into the crayon, just a little bit, moving it around a little bit. Some of these colors are a little strong. That's the downside of these watercolor crayons. They're a little bit strong, but they're beautiful. The Caron d'Ache really aren't from the same standard colors that the professional watercolor, you know, standardized colors are. But that's okay, they're very beautiful. Just enjoy your tools. Use them. Use them and use them. Might be time to put some green in. Shall I try some green? Getting pretty wet here. I want to get rid of some of this, little bit of this watercolor crayon. Some more, little bit darker here and there. Let this travel through a little bit. This is going to settle down and get quite a bit darker because it's wet. And so when we work wet, it's going to dry lighter because it's watercolor. now going to lay the painting down. Off of my little easel so that it doesn't run down. That way my little lily pads will stay where I put them. Might as well make it a little bit watercolory with some nice drippy things. Why not make it look like a watercolor? Now we've put some paint into it, I'm going to go back in with a little bit more texture with my crayons. Monet used quite a lot of line in his work a lot of times, even though he was painting in oils. He did have fun with his lines. I'm working them in so that they're going in while the water is on the paper. You know, the paper is wet. So that will diffuse these lines nicely. Not dark enough. To go in with some dark paint in some areas, I think. Still not quite right. Let's try this. Almost black. Okay, we'll mix a few darks. We need some really dark darks in here. you don't get the values in, it's not going to work. Can't leave it alone. I'm using my fingernail, adding some more texture.